Hi, I'm Megan Weber, and I'm an extension educator focusing on aquatic invasive species at the University of Minnesota. I was out walking along the trails near my home here in Big Lake, Minnesota the other day and noticed that the reed canary grass is getting to a point where it's pretty easy to pick out and identify. So I thought I'd take you all out on a walk and go look at the reed canary grass and see if I can show you some tips on how to identify it. So let's go check that out. All right, here we are on the walking trails, and you can see all of this reed canary grass lining the pond here. And as we go on, I'm going to show you some closer details that you can tell how to know that this is reed canary grass. So the first thing we'll do is look at the stem. You can see it has this pretty smooth, round stem, and as you look real close, right where that leaf blade is meeting and wrapping around the stem, you can see that membrane that sticks out. That transparent membrane, that's called a ligule. And reed canary grass has these pretty big transparent ligules. You can see it kind of pulling away from the stem as I tug on the leaf there. The other thing you'll look at is the width of the leaves. So the leaves are up to about 3/4 of an inch wide, and they oftentimes have kind of a rough texture. So here's the ruler now. You can see this one's just shy of 3/4 of an inch in width as I look at the leaf blade width here. The next thing that we'll look at is the color of the seed heads, and you'll see that there's actually some variation. So these ones are looking kind of a purpley color, but right next to it, there's this patch, and these have much more green seed heads. So there's a lot of variation that you can see in the coloration of them. You can see this patch is even more purple than the one we saw before. So those are all the tips that I have for you today. I hope you found this identification video helpful, and keep your eyes out for reed canary grass as you're out and about.